This week, President Obama called on community colleges to produce 5 million more graduates by 2020, saying the schools that provide skills, training, and a less expensive path to college are crucial to America's competitiveness. Between 2007 to 2009, community colleges across the country saw a 17% enrollment surge. And that's happening right here in New Hampshire, too. Gene Mackin joins us live to explain why. Gene?
Well, enrollment is up 11% across the New Hampshire community college system. It's the second year with a double-digit rise. And many students say the economy brought them to class.
More students are moving through the halls at Manchester Community College, one of the state's seven community colleges with a surge in enrollments. Up to 2,800 students here earning credits.
I hope to open up my own photography business.
Well, I'm studying for business management to someday own my own cafe.
A lot of people end up coming to community colleges to get trained exactly what they need to do and go to work.
I have three grown children. Two of them are in college now, so it's my turn.
Patty Tortellini is a mother from Londonderry going back to school for her business communications degree.
It's something I've always wanted to do. It's something I'm doing for myself.
We can record the percent of light that's transmitted.
Many students say they're signing up for classes at community colleges because they're affordable, close to home, and have flexible hours. Anatoly Ilyuk was laid off after 17 years in maintenance. Now he's studying for a new career in heating and air conditioning.
I used to build the houses, and I know how much it meant to be for the family to have a house, to have a heat in a home for the winter time.
New England has really discovered community colleges.
MCC President Susan Heward says the school is evolving with the needs of its students.
We're offering eight-week classes. We're doing more on weekends. We're doing more in the evening. We're really trying to understand who wants to come and what it is they need.
And we're told there's a growing demand for degrees in technical and automotive programs, along with the healthcare field. Reporting live, Gene Mackin, WMUR News 9.